Okay, welcome back.
欢迎回来.
Yeah, we're really getting into some nice, deep questions and answers here.
今天早上我们确实开始比较深入地进行一些问答的那个项目。
I think it's important to always keep in mind
我觉得这个是非常重要的，就是要牢记一点。
That you are opening up to an experience.
就是我们现在其实迈向的或敞开的是一种切身的体验。
You're not trying to accumulate knowledge.
我们在这并不是要在积累更多的知识。
Or accumulate anything.
或者是积累任何东西。
It's more like an inner letting go.
我们实际上在内心里面在做放下消除的工作。
And be taken into an experience.
然后让我们自己被带到这样的一个体验当中去。And
you cannot really know the how in terms of a formula.
因为你自己实际上是永远不会知道就是去如何去做这件事情，这是一个没有公式的一个过程。Because
in this world we're so used to steps and formulas.
因为在这个世界中我们就非常习惯的，我们想要找到一些公式，想要找到一些流程。
But with spirituality, it's more willingness to let go.
但是在灵性的这条道路上，我们所要做的就是有这个愿心，要一而再、再而三的交托。
Let go of control of everything.
把我们对所有事情的控制权都要交托出去。
Because we never really had control in the first place.
因为事实上，我们从一开始对任何事情都没有控制。
It's just been a game of control.
就实际上我们是在自己跟自己玩一个游戏，好像是拥有控制的这样的一个游戏。The
ego says without control and rules all would be chaos.
因为小我跟我们说，如果我们不对事情加以控制的话，一切就是混乱状态。But
Jesus teaches us that without control and rules all will be love.
但是基督就教导我们，如果没有我们的控制或者是 这些条规的话，那么一切剩下的就只有爱。So
in one sense, we have to go beyond our conditioning.
所以对于我们来讲，我们一定要突破我们这些固有的局限性。Because
conditioning always is limiting.
因为这些局限性就是对我们思想加以禁锢。And
true freedom is our natural state.
因为真正的自由才是我们本身的。
But this is a freedom in mind, not a freedom of the body. The Course in Miracles tells us, what do you want? Freedom of the body or freedom of the mind? For both you cannot have.
因为你不可能两者兼有。
And most of us have sought for freedom in terms of the body.
对于我们很多人来讲，我们实际上在找寻的是一种肉体上的自由。
More money, more choices.
更多的金钱，更多的选择权。
More flexibility.
更多的任何方面的灵活性。
More options.
或者更多的选择。
But these do not produce real freedom.
但这个其实上是造，是没法带来真正的自由的。
It just leads to more complexity.
它只会造成更多复杂的这种幻象。
And then a sense of depression.
然后给我们带来的是一种压抑的感觉。
At not being able to fulfill the pursuit.
而且会使我们感觉到我们实在永远是追求不到自己想要的东西。
And such is the case with ambition for this world.
所以这个也是我们对这个世界上的这些，野心。野心，对，但是如果是有任何的野心的话，这个也是它的后果。The
more that you get, the more that you want.
你想要的越多。
When you get, the more you want.
你看上去你得到的越多，你就会想要的越多。
I know it's crazy, but that's how the ego works. It's, you keep reaching for something and never achieving it.
所谓的真理就是你所得到的越多你实际上状态就会越来越高
And so eventually you have to stop the pursuing
所以到最终你在某一个程度上你一定要需要停下来去追寻任何的东西
And this comes back to the goal of meditation
然后这个也回到了我们所讲的这个冥想的最终的目标
To drop beneath these thoughts of pursuit.
这个目标实际上就是要让我们沉淀下来，沉淀到这个表象的这些还有追求的目标之下。
There is a workbook lesson in A Course in Miracles.
在奇迹课程里边的练习手册有这么一课。
That says, I rest in God.
他说我在上主的心境内休息。
When I first came upon that lesson, I said, oh, this is delightful.
我第一次在练习这个课程的时候觉得这个实在是太令人喜悦了。
I think I stayed on that lesson for an entire week.
我当时在做这个练习一直做了一个星期持续不断的。
I just felt it was calling me deeper and deeper.
我觉得这一刻就一直在很深处在召唤我。And
so that is important to remember in terms of what this is all about.
所以这个是我们需要记住的很重要的一件事情。
We are told that rest does not come from sleeping, but from waking.
奇迹课程教导我们说, 其实真正的休息不是来自于睡眠,而是来自于觉醒。
And so that's why we need to wake up in order to have our eternal rest in God.
所以我们想要在上主的这一体之境内永远的安息的话，就一定要觉醒，从这个梦境中觉醒过来。
But before you wake up, you have to have a lucid dream.
但是当你觉醒，在你觉醒过来之前，你应该有这种非常放松的这种梦境。放松的梦境 ，lucid dream，就是说你自己知道自己在做梦的这样的一个境界。
Yes, that's just that you're aware.
所以在那个境界中你实际上是很明白自己是在做梦的叫清明梦吧
And therefore you're no longer frightened by the dream
在这种境界中你实际上是不会被梦里面的一切东西所吓到
So the trick of this world is an amnesia of forgetting love
所以这个世界实际上是对爱的一种病症这个病症就是忘记了爱
And falling into a deep sleep.
所以就是心灵完全处于沉睡状态。
And then forgetting that you're sleeping.
然后并且忘记了是自己实际上是在做梦。
Which is just a way of protecting the dream.
在这种状态实际上就是用来保护我们的这个梦境，不受干扰。
So again, as this morning, let's open it up to questions.
所以就像我们今天早上一样，现在就让我们打开，就是欢迎大家提问。
Whatever your practical experiences.
就是你在实践的过程中遇到过有任何的问题。
However you are experiencing this world.
然后还有你对这个世界有任何的疑惑或者是问题。
You have to start with this.
你一定要从这个角度开始。
So that this seems very practical and relevant to you.
只有这样的话，就是说我们所讲的内容，才能变得非常的实际，而且对你很息息相关。
And then, little by little, the spirit will unwind you from this world.
然后一点一点的，这个圣灵才会帮助你的这个心灵逐渐的从这个世界的枷锁中解脱出来。
And the dreams will become happy dreams.
然后这个世界的梦境就会变得非常快乐。
Because you cannot wake up directly from a nightmare.
因为你是不可能从一个噩梦中直接醒过来的。
You have to first reach the happy dreams of forgiveness.
你首先要达到一个就是已经完全宽恕一切的这样一个快乐的梦境的状态。
Where you feel very inspired.
在这个状态你会感觉到一切都非常有启发，你是受神的启发的。
Every day you jump out of bed to greet the new day.
然后每天你都迫不及待地起床去迎接新的一天。
And can't wait to see what the Spirit will show you.
不能急于的就已经不想等待，迫不及待地去迎接每天的新的经历。
Okay. That's good. Just speak right.
Okay. 刚才听到大卫老师讲以后，我就很想就问一个自己的问题。因为我现在正在学习和宽恕。但是我现在在宽恕一个曾经的一个比较大的，对我来说是一个比较大的一个事件。
After everything that you just said, I want to ask a personal question. I've been practicing forgiveness, and right now I'm actually trying to forgive something that had a huge impact.
我就邀请耶稣来帮我宽恕、释放。那个情绪最开始呢，就是一种对他人的一种愤怒、怨恨这样子。
I invited Jesus to help me forgive and release this emotion, and the emotion originally was attack thoughts and anger toward other people.
然后之后呢，这个情绪就变成了就自己的一种罪疚，然后自己的一种悲伤、痛苦。
And gradually, this emotion changed into a feeling of guilt and sadness, disappointment.
然后再继续宽恕下去，释放这个情绪，最后就到了一种，好像就是非常的恐惧，非常害怕死亡，然后以及非常的孤单、孤独的这种感觉。
And the more I practice forgiveness on the same thing, the feeling keep changing, and in the end, it turned into some deep fear of death and fear of feeling lonely.
然后到了这样一个情绪以后呢？就人就感觉好像关进了一个黑暗的房间一样，然后就没有办法，就是请耶稣帮我来一起宽恕释放，可是这个情绪就没有办法，很好的释放出去。就即使每天不断的释放，但这个情绪仍然都还在。
So when I was in that state, I felt like I was locked in a dark room, and though I invited Jesus to help me forgive this and release this emotion.It seems like everything I tried, I'm stuck in this darkness.
然后我也尝试了很多方法，就是用练习里面的，光明已经来临，我已宽恕了世界，或者是不断的说耶稣我爱你，耶稣请救救我。但是，有时候会感觉到看到光明，感受到爱，但是，这样的情况它可能过不了多久，又回到了这种黑暗的状态。
I've tried many ways to release this darkness, including practicing the workbook lesson, Light Has Come, or just repeating in my mind, please help me, Jesus. Even though sometimes I can experience a brief release, I will inevitably come back to this darkness.
所以就好像是两股力量，就是小我跟圣灵的两股力量在交战，然后这两股就势均力敌。人就一直在这个情绪里面就卡住了，就没有办法从它里面走出来。我就想请问一下大卫老师，有没有比较好的办法能够帮助我
？So it feels like the ego and the Holy Spirit are fighting, and they actually have equal power. So I feel very stuck in between. I just want to see whether you have a better way to help me.
Yes, well, I think it's very effective what you're doing in calling upon Jesus to come and help you.
你就是说你所尝试这个就是请求圣灵在你的心灵中请求圣灵来帮助你，实际上是非常有效的一个方法。
And as you do so, the ego will protest and will throw up its.Defenses and its arguments.
就每当你请求圣灵帮忙的时候，小我实际上就会非常痛苦的挣扎，它会 抛出自己的那些拿手的武器啊，或者说是保护啊什么的。
The ego will speak first and loudest, and so you have to let it go through its antics.
嗯，因为小我总是第一个发言，而且总是会最大声的发言，所以有些时候你还是必须得允许它，就是走过这个过程。
And it is quite common for the emotions to switch, like you say, from anger to a sense of guilt or sadness, and then ultimately to a fear or aloneness.
就是你刚才所描述的，你的情绪在不停的转换，从一开始的愤怒啊，后来变到痛苦、悲伤，然后变到就是这种对死亡的恐惧，实际上是非常正常的。
It's like you're looking at the facets of a diamond, and it has many different angles. The ego emotion has many different angles.
就像你看到一个钻石的这个切割面，它就一个钻石，它有很多的切断面。然后小我也是这样，有很多不同的层面。
For myself, I had to face also this feeling of being very alone.
对于我自己来讲，我曾经也有过一段时间是。
And I remember reading in the text where Jesus says, "You really believe you are alone unless you are with another body."
然后我记得当时去读那个奇迹课程正文里面，然后基督耶稣说，你是认为自己是孤身一人的，除非你跟其他的身体在一起。
And when I read that, I remember saying to Jesus, "That's right." I do believe that.
然后当时在我读到这个的时候，我就跟他说：“你说的太对了，我确实是有这样的信念。”
I told Jesus, "Yes, I believe in companionship."
然后我其实相信同伴能够给我带来陪伴的感觉。
And that belief is my belief in connection and being together.
这个也是建立在我相信，就是说能够跟别人有链接，需要。其他的身体来才能跟我有链接。
And he said, "Okay, then, I will just have to show you another way."
然后他的答案当时给我就是说，那好吧，那我需要向你展示一些其他的体验。
And this was the same thing when he was saying, "Trust in me to meet all of your needs."
这就是好像他当时曾经跟我说，你要相信我。能够满足你所有的要求，所有的需求。
I said to Jesus, "Well, maybe that works in heaven, but down here, we need money."
然后他当时跟我说的时候，我就说：“你的这一套可能在天国行得通，但是在我们这里，我们是需要钱才能生活的。”
And I can't just walk out to the tree and start pulling money off of the tree.
然后我也做不到直接走到外面的任何一草一木，然后直接拉着他们。就可以从那里面拿钱出来。
And he said, "Yes, yes, I know. You believe that."
然后他说，我知道，这是你的信念，是这样教你的。
So he was always listening to what I had to say and saying, "Yes, I understand. That's what you believe."
所以他总是非常耐心的聆听我的对他的这些发问和我的这些抱怨，然后他很耐心的说，我明白这是你的信念体系上所造成的这些想法。
Another related belief was I was reading lesson 76.
然后另外一个相关的一个信念就是我当时在读第76个练习手册的时候。
And the lesson is, "I am under no laws but God's."
当时就说我是不受任何的法则所局限的，只有上主的法则才能局限我。
And he said, "You believe the laws of medicine, of economics."
然后他在那一课里面就说，实际上你是相信你是，任何的法则都可以在你身上应用的，比如说像医疗，像对比，还有那个 medicine 什么。
Yeah, and I said, "Okay, I can see that."
然后我说我明白，可以看到这个。
And then he said, "You believe in the laws of friendship."
他说你还是相信友情这样的一个法则。
And I said, "But that's good, right? It's good to have friends."
然后我跟他说，但这个信仰是好的，对不对？因为我觉得友谊是好的东西。
He said, well, actually the ego made up the laws of friendship too.
然后他就说,这个实际上小我,友谊也是小我营造出来的。
What needs to be a good friend or a close friend?
就是说什么样才是好朋友或者是比较近的朋友,这些都是小我营造出来的。
And so again, that was a stretch for my mind.
所以当时对我来讲,其实是一个挑战,去听耶稣说这些话。
So what Jesus is saying is that we have to trust Him and follow Him.
所以他当时实际上就是在跟我说,我一定要100%的相信他,并且去跟随他。
So that He can show us a sense of intimacy and connection.
就这样他才能把我们带到一种新的体验中,去体验这种亲密的关系和链接的关系。
That is not dependent on the body.
然后这种亲密的和链接的体验是不取决于我们必须要有其他的身体在身边的。
Because our definitions of love and connection are very much based on bodies being together.
因为我们在这个世界中对爱的定义还有对链接的定义是完全是取决于我们一定要有其他的身体在才可能的。
And I would say, why does it feel so terrible when the bodies go apart?
然后我当时就会问,为什么当身体分开的时候的感觉是那么痛苦呢?
He said, it's because you believe that there is a break in communication when the bodies go apart.
他说你之所以有这种痛苦的感觉,是因为你相信当身体分开的时候,交流也中断了。
The more you open up, the more you see that there are blocks to true love.
所以当你在这条路上走得越深的时候,你会越看到实际上...
Blocks to true love. The more that... It seems that the more you go inside, you find there are blocks to true love.
你在一条路上走得越深,你就会发觉到更多的去阻挡这个爱的这种障碍,你能看清这些障碍。
Yes, and these blocks have to be uncovered in the mind. It can be the same feeling of feeling very located. While we feel located to a body in a particular place in space. It can feel very, very alone. I remember maybe about a couple years ago watching a movie, it was a space movie with Sandra Bullock and George Clooney.
Gravity. 就几年前的时候,我印象中我看到这样的一个电影,好像中文叫《地心引力》吧,那样的一个电影。
When the astronaut just went spinning off in space.
然后当时他们的那个两个宇航员就在宇宙中就是迷失了。And
when I talked to people, they said, oh, they saw that scene and they felt very alone when she was spinning. Because she didn't, her body didn't seem to be connected to the ship or to anything in particular, it was just out spinning in space. And this is what happens when we are so identified with the body. We need to have experiences that show us that we are more than a body. Sometimes people will tell me they have a near-death experience and they view their body from outside.
有些时候有的朋友会跟我说他们有这种濒死经验，然后他们在这种经验中是会从其他的角度去看回到自己的身体。
Sometimes people have a dream at night and they can fly during their dreams and they feel so much more free.
然后有的时候他们会在梦中有这种飞行的体验，然后在梦里面觉得自己是非常自由的。
But in some way, we have to have an experience that we are more than in a body.
但是不管怎么样，我们到某种情况下，一定要有这样体验。这种体验能够告诉我们，我们实际上是比一具身体要多得多。我们真正的身份是远远大于这一具身体。
And even with relationships, the spirit can use the relationship to expand the mind.
哪怕是对于人际关系来讲，如果我们把人际关系交给圣灵的话，它可以运用这个人际关系去拓展我们的心灵。
The more that we have open communication and transparent communication, we feel more expansive.
如果在人际关系中，我们能够做到，不断的去进行这种透明的交流，然后这样的话，我们的心灵就会被一步一步的展开。
So, a helpful prayer to Jesus could be, "Please show me how to use the body to expand my perception."
所以，如果就是说要想向耶稣祈祷的话，一个非常有用的一个祈祷词可以就是说，请你帮助我利用这具身体来不断的拓展我的心灵。
And this expanded perception gives us a feeling of a much stronger connection to everyone and everything.
当你在这种就拓展这个角度下面生活的话，你会感觉到你会跟更多的人有更深的连接。
We do have to let those emotions come up into awareness.
然后就是说在这个过程中，如果有一些强烈的情绪的话，我们一定要需要允许这个情绪浮现到表面上来。
And it can be helpful to find somebody to talk about the emotions or even to journal and write the emotions out.
如果你有一些信任的朋友的话，如果跟他们去交流这些强烈的感受，或者说去把一些用日记的方式写出来，都有可能是比较有帮助的方法。
I think the time in my life when I felt the most alone was when I was a teenager in early 20s.
在我的生命中，当我在是在二十几岁年轻的时候，是感觉到最强烈的孤独感。
I was keeping so many emotions concealed and pressed inside of my mind.
因为当时我实际上是把我这个内心里面的这种各种各样的感受和情绪都深深的埋藏起来。
And at that time, I didn't have A Course in Miracles.
那个时候我也没有接触到奇迹课程。
But I had a very, very loving dog.
但我有一只非常非常爱我的狗。
And I could sit down and cry the emotions out, and the dog would lick my face.
然后我当时就可以每天的就任由眼泪冲刷着我的这些心灵，然后那只狗就会在我面前一直舔我的眼泪，舔干了泪水。
I called it the pink tongue treatment.
然后我把它当就叫做粉红舌头疗法。
I needed many hours and actually many years of pink tongue treatment to let all the emotions come.
我当时需要不仅是每天几个小时，甚至很多年这样的疗法，去允许我把所有的情绪都释放出来。
But I could see I was feeling much better as I would not let them up with my parents or with my sister.
当时我确实感觉到这个对我来讲是非常有效，因为面对我的父母和我的姐姐，我是没法把这个情绪带出来的。
So I think that's why Jesus used the dog.
所以当时就是圣灵就把这条狗作为我的治疗师。
Because it's safer.Much safer. So if that's the prayer of your heart, it's just show me the way to release this deep fear of being alone.
So if this is your 愿心，就是希望圣灵给你指引一条道路去释放 你内心的这些情绪的话。
And also to know that this is a course in the spirit's use of relationship.
然后另外我还想强调一点，就是我们这个奇迹课程是一个让圣灵把我们的人际关系交托给圣灵的这样的一个道路。
So Jesus knows the relationships that we need to open up our heart.
所以圣灵和基督实际上是知道我们需要什么样的关系才能把我们的心门敞开。
And for me, the prayer was always make it obvious.
所以我的祈祷词通常就是让它变得非常的明确，就是说让我没有任何的疑问。
Because, the ego is quite attracted to guilt.
因为小我是总是很对那个罪疚非常上瘾的。
And we all know the experience of drawing forth witnesses of guilt or pain.
然后我们都知道就这种经验，当我们感觉到罪疚的时候，周围的人和物就会反映出来我们的罪疚感。
When we're tricked by the ego, then we draw forth witnesses to perpetuate the ego.
当我们中了小我的这个诡计的时候，我们通常就会目击这样的一些人和事情，去维持这个小我的信念。
And sometimes we will go into a pattern of avoidance to try to avoid relationships because of past hurt and pain.
然后有的时候，因为过去我们曾经在人际关系中受到伤害，我们现在有可能会不自觉地会回避或者避免某些新的关系的到来。
But actually, when we avoid relationships, we are avoiding the means to awaken.
但是当我们回避新的关系的时候，实际上我们是在回避圣灵所给你提供的这个通向心灵自由的方法。
We need to learn to begin to thank all of our relationships for the mirroring that they are offering.
我们需要改变我们的态度，我们需要看到所有的关系实际上是对我们心灵的一面镜子，然后我们要对此保持感激。
Even the difficult relationships, there is a lesson for us to learn from them.
哪怕是那种最艰难的关系，它在中间一定是有我们需要练习的功课的。
So we can start to honestly ask ourselves, what was this relationship showing me about my mind?
所以我们实际上是可以非常诚恳地去问一下自己，这个关系到底是反射出来我心灵中的什么的问题和状态。
And once we can see that, then we can see the gift, we can see the blessing.
如果我们真的能够看透它反射出来我们心灵的状态是什么的话，那么我们就能够看到它的能给我带来的礼物是什么。
We can see that this relationship that we thought was so difficult was showing something that was denied from awareness.
我们就能看到，就是说，不管是多么难的一段关系，实际上它都会给我们反映出来我们所在心里面试图埋藏的东西。
So.We are never meant to be dependent on the relationship.
所以我并不是说我们需要依靠着我们的人际关系去怎么样。
We are really meant to find the Holy Spirit inside the relationship.
我们需要在我们的人际关系中看到圣灵的临在。
Because really we all share the same purpose to wake up.
因为我们实际上每一个人都有这个愿心，是要觉醒的愿心。
So little by little, we become more fulfilled from our purpose inside.
所以，当我们心里面有这样的一个目的，是觉醒的目的的话，我们会逐渐的会被这个 little by little we will be satisfied.
Fulfilled from within.
所以当我们有这个觉醒作为我们唯一的目的的时候，我们内心就会被越来越充满和满足。
And our motive for relationships turns around.
然后我们对从一段关系中需要寻求的东西也会被改变。
Instead of trying to get things from the other person.
然后与其是希望从弟兄身上获取任何东西。
we see there's an opportunity to give and to collaborate.
然后我们就会看到，实际上这种关系提供了一个机会，让我可以有机会给予，而且有机会和其他人合作。
And that's how Jesus took me out of that sense of loneliness.
这个实际上就是圣灵如何把我从那种孤独感中带出来的一个过程。
He had me traveling and meeting people from different cultures, different countries.
他指引我在全世界各地旅行，然后去跟全世界各地不同的朋友会面。
Learning to forgive and to practice forgiveness everywhere that I went.
然后不管是我去了哪儿，都可以不停的去实践宽恕。
So that I had that feeling of love and connection stronger than ever inside.
所以这样的话，我才会在从内心由自而发的感觉到越来越强的这种满足感和奇迹感。
If I was traveling and it seemed helpful to have a travel partner, then Jesus would send in a travel partner.
如果在我旅行的时候，我觉得需要有一个朋友跟我一起做这段旅行的话，那么圣灵也会派适当的人选在我身边跟我一起旅行。
If I would go to a country where I didn't speak the language, then he would send me an interpretation partner.
如果我到了一个陌生的国家，我不会说当地的语言的话，圣灵总是会指派一位合适的人选来帮我做翻译。
Yeah, I found that there were always many opportunities for collaboration.
然后我就发现我的生命中充满了这样的机会，去跟其他弟兄合作。
When I was first traveling, I would stay at a hostel. He would tell me, tomorrow morning you're going to talk to that girl.
然后在一开始的旅行的时候，有时候我会住在那种比较廉价的酒店里面，然后圣灵就会跟我说，明天早上你需要去跟这个人说话。
And I would say, really?
然后我说是吗？为什么？
He'd say, wait and see tomorrow morning.
他说你明天早上知道为什么。
And then the next morning, I would be fixing breakfast, and the girl would come up and start talking to me.
然后第二天早上，我可能就在他那个公共的书房开始给自己准备早餐，然后他所说的那个人就会走到我身边来跟我说话。
And so even though I was shy, Jesus would give me a little instruction and premonition, so I wouldn't be so shocked.
所以当时因为我当时非常的害羞，所以圣灵总是这种给我一些提前的这种提醒，以至于当事情发生的时候，我不至于过于的害羞。
And the more these things happen, the more I could trust what I was hearing.
这种经历越多，我就越来越加深我的那个对圣灵的信任。
So our trust starts off very small, but it keeps growing bigger and bigger.
所以我对圣灵的信任从一开始实际上也是很少的信任，但是他就是在这么多年的实践中一直在加强，一直在加深。
So we shouldn't be hard on ourselves at the beginning when we're just beginning to develop trust.
所以在一开始我们刚刚开始培养我们对圣灵这个信任的时候，我们不要对自己过于苛刻。
It can come in many, many different ways. Trust, development of trust.
这个对信任的培养，实际上最终会从各个角度会来到我们的身边。
When I adopted this little three-legged cat, a little kitten named Tripod.
所以当时我还就是收养了一只三条腿的一只猫，我管它叫三脚架。
She was very frightened when she first came to my house.
她一开始刚被我领养的时候是非常害怕的。
She would run under the furniture and hide.
然后她总是会躲到那个家具的这个底下。
But for many years, I kept loving her and treating her with gentleness and kindness. She slowly came out of her fear.
但是就是很多年以来，我一直就是以一种持续的爱去照顾她。去看待他，然后他逐渐的就摆脱这种恐惧。
She felt that she could trust me. She felt more relaxed around me, and so she became more affectionate.
因为他感觉到他可以信任我，而且可以在我面前完全的放松，所以他就是变得非常对我非常亲密。
But we have to be very patient with ourselves because some of our beliefs are very deeply rooted.
但是我们需要有耐心，因为我们的这些很多的信念实际上是根深蒂固的。
And that's why Jesus calls it the development of trust.
所以基督在奇迹课程里面说，你要培养你的这个对我的信心。
We're slowly pulling our trust away from the ego, and we're giving the trust to the Holy Spirit.
因为我们是需要撤销我们对小我的这个信心，然后逐渐把这个信心给圣灵。
And so for most people, it takes a while, it takes time to be convinced.
所以对于很多人来讲，这个过程是需要花一些时间的。我们需要一些时间让圣灵来说服我们。
If you had a child who was sleeping and dreaming and having a nightmare,
如果你有一个孩子，这个孩子在睡觉的时候，做了一些噩梦。
And you went to shake the child to wake the child up.
然后你过去使劲地摇这个孩子，想把他摇醒。
The child may interpret the shaking as part of the nightmare.
这个孩子有可能把你对他的摇晃也加进到他的噩梦当中去，认为是噩梦的一部分。
As if it's being grabbed by a monster.
他可能会认为他当时他在梦里面陷入在梦里面，然后被一个恶魔所摇晃。
And so this is why Jesus has to find a way to gently wake us up.
所以这就是为什么基督要找到一个方法，是很温柔的把我们唤醒。
Because we're so convinced about the environment that's around us.
因为我们对我们所见的这个一切的外在的这个表象是深信不疑的。
We believe that the people are real people.
然后我们相信人真的是人。
And that the world has real dangers.
然后这个世界上是充满了真正的危险。
And Jesus has to show us gently that this is not really so.
然后基督是需要非常温柔地提醒我们，这个我们所认为的这一切都不是真实的。
He has to teach us that this is a game.
他会教导我们，这一切是你自己玩的一个游戏。
And we have to learn to laugh at the game.
我们需要对这个游戏一笑置之。
Instead of reacting so strong.
而不是一个劲儿对他反抗。
So just keep asking Jesus to show you.
所以我建议你还是要持续的去向圣灵，让圣灵帮助你，请求他的帮助。
And he'll bring in everything that you need to feel more of that connection.
他会给你提供你所需要的一切，让你感觉到这种非常深的链接感。
我想知道，就是说，圣灵可以变成小我，小我是不是可以变成小我？比如说，当我在圣灵身上看到小我的时候，是圣灵在看还是小我在看？
在什么身上看到小我？
在兄弟的身上，包括在我自己身上也一样。
OK。The question is, if I see the ego on my brother or on myself, whose eyes am I seeing it from? Am I seeing it from the ego or from the Holy Spirit? Will the Holy Spirit ever turn to become the ego?
The Holy Spirit has the function to look beyond the ego.
然后圣灵实际上他就会看，就是说看透这个小我的伎俩。
And the Holy Spirit is so good at that function. The Holy Spirit always just sees the light beyond the ego.
圣灵的这个任务，他完成的如此的好，他就是永远只是看到光明的一面。
The Holy Spirit cannot even see the error.
圣灵实际上是看不到任何错误的。
Looking beyond the behavior and beyond the error, all the way back to the light.
他也不会看到在行为上或者是任何层面的错误，他只是看到光明。
So, first we have to expose the ego.
所以我们要做第一步，首先是要暴露小我。
Because the more we expose the ego, the closer we come to the Holy Spirit.
我们越暴露小我，我们就会离圣灵越近。
The Holy Spirit has no secrets.
圣灵是没有秘密的。
So as long as we keep and hide secrets, we are holding off the Holy Spirit.
所以每当我们在保护自己的秘密或者隐藏什么东西的时候，我们实际上就是离圣灵越来越远。
So the first phase of forgiveness is not hiding the ego.
所以我们在 在练习宽恕的第一阶段，就是不要有任何的秘密，不要保护任何的秘密。
But then the second phase is learning to be with the Holy Spirit all the time.
然后第二阶段实际上就是要我们要随时随地的请求圣灵跟我们在一起。
So whenever you see the ego on yourself or on a brother or a sister,
所以每当你是在弟兄身上或者是在你自己身上看到小我的时候，
you are looking through the filter of the ego.
你总是通过小我的这个过滤镜在看的。
Because the ego always sees mistakes and is counting the mistakes.
因为小我总是要看到错误，而且是不同是不停的在这个数这个错误。
It's always counting against someone, always counting their sins or their errors.
他是一直在不停的在计算着别人的错误，计算着别人的这个罪恶。
But once we align with the Holy Spirit, we just feel the perfection.
但是如果一旦我们是跟圣灵是一体的话，那我们看到的应该永远只是圆满性。
We hear the call for love.
然后我们听到的是别人对爱的呼求。
And we answer that with love.
然后我们对爱的呼求的这个召唤，我们的答案就是爱。
And when we extend the love, we feel the love even stronger.
然后每当我们推恩爱的时候，我们自己对爱的体验也会更深。
So that's how forgiveness works.
所以这个就是宽恕真正到底是怎么工作的，怎么运作的。
这样，我觉得在我这方面，我分两个情况来看。一方面的时候，有时候你觉得你看到了兄弟身上的肌肉，实际上你就像刚才说大卫说的，看到了他的罪，然后你就会跟他纠缠在一起。但有些时候，你会观察到自己，就像上午大卫讲的，你只是看到这是肌肉的一种想囚禁你的手段，然后你就会对他感到很有趣或一笑置之。我觉得我不认为这是肌肉的眼光来看。
I think there are two parts. The first part is if I see mistakes or errors in my brothers, if I got involved in it, then that is seeing it from the ego. But on the other hand, if I see it and I realize that it is a reflection of the ego, it is a reflection of something that is in the mind, then I can just laugh at it.In that way, I don't really think I'm seeing it from the ego.
Yes, if you can see it for what it is and have no reaction to it.
事实上你是可以看到，不管是看到什么，你可以对它实际上是没有任何的反应的。
Then you are not caught in the ego.
如果你对它是没有任何的这种情绪的反应，那么你就没有陷入它。
If I think back to the stories of Jesus in the Bible,
如果我去回想当时在圣经和中的那个基督耶稣的那个故事，
it was like Jesus could read the thoughts of everyone that was around him.
当时的状况是他实际上是可以感受到这身边所有人的念头和想法的。
But he didn't react.To any of those thoughts, he was very peaceful and calm.
但是他就是非常平静的，他也不去有任何的反应对其他人的想法。
And even if he would speak those thoughts, people were shocked that he could read their thoughts.
然后有的时候他会把一些想法说出来，然后周围的人就会非常惊讶，基督是可以读懂他们的脑子里面的想法。
But he was not shocked because he knew it was all one mind.
但是他并没有什么觉得惊讶，因为他知道所有的这些想法都是存在于一体的心灵当中的。
He saw the thoughts but did not react to them at all.
他能看到这些攻击的念头或者是其他念头，但他不会去陷入他们当中。
And you can just imagine how wonderful your relationships will be when you do that.
然后你可以想象，如果你能够做到这一点的话，你的人际关系该是多么的容易。
This is when we can transform our
relationship into suffering relationship. Is that correct? And actually, my question is how to transform our special relationship into a separate relationship.
他的问题就是说，这个是不是就是从特殊关系转换到神圣关系的方法？还有就是到底应该如何转换，把特殊关系转换成神圣关系
？Yes, there are 9 chapters in A Course in Miracles that talk very specifically about this topic.
但是奇迹课程里面，基督花了9章的时间和空间去把谈这个问题。
It starts on chapter 15 and runs through chapter
24.
And when you are tempted to blame someone or to project hurt onto someone, or even when you're tempted to get rid of somebody and to break off the relationship,
甚至当你有这个冲动去摆脱一些人，或者是把一段关系结束的时候，
this is the time to remember the purpose for the relationship.
这个时候实际上就是需要你去记起你这个关系到底是什么目的。
It's always good to invite the Holy Spirit to come into the relationship.
你应该一直是请求圣灵进入你的关系当中去。
And once the Holy Spirit enters, it can become very intense in relationship.
但是一旦圣灵进入到了你的关系当中，你的关系可能会变得非常的激烈。
Because when you invite the Holy Spirit to come in.
一旦你邀请到圣灵去进入你的关系当中，
You're really saying, I want to change the purpose for this relationship.
你实际上，你的心灵是在说，我希望改变我这段关系的目的。
From one of hatred to one of true love.
我想把我这段关系的目的从仇恨转变到真正的爱。
So,It's really you're asking for a purification to occur.
所以你实际上所寻求的是把这段关系净化。
And the reason the relationship becomes so intense is because the ego does not like the new purpose for the relationship.
然后之所以为什么这个你的关系可能反而会变得更激化的原因，就是因为小我是会对你这个新的目的非常的不满。
Because the ego gave it the old purpose and it wants to use the old purpose to maintain itself.
因为小我给你的关系，这个旧的目的实际上是小我所赋予的，然后他希望借用这个旧的目的去达成他自己的愿望。
So when you invite the Holy Spirit, you're saying, I want to unplug from hatred.
所以每当你邀请圣灵来到你的关系的时候，实际上你就在说，我希望从小我的这个目的中释放出来。
And if hatred has become a habit, then the whole relationship starts to shake.
如果你那个关系当中实际上已经是建立在仇恨的基础上的话，那么当你从小我的这个目的中解脱出来的时候，这个关系就会变得非常的摇摆不堪。
And this is an important phase of maintaining the trust.
那这个时刻实际上就非常重要的是，你一定要有对圣灵的信心。
You have to allow the Holy Spirit to do the work.
你必须要给这个圣灵空间，让他去做他的工作。
Even though you may be tempted to say goodbye, I don't need this anymore.
那个时候你可能会非常有这个冲动，说算了，我根本不想再跟这个人纠缠下去。
Yeah. So.These relationships do turn into holy or sacred relationships.
所以最终这个特殊关系是可以会被转变成神圣关系的。
Because you share the same purpose.
它能够被转换的原因就是因为你已经转换了这个目的。
You're going to have open communication.
你需要在这个关系中开始有这种空开诚布公的交流。
You're not going to hide or protect feelings.
你不能再继续的去掩藏或者是保护你自己的这个感受。
You're going to have honest communication.
你要有非常诚恳的交流。
And that will even become more consistent as you go along.
然后这种交流会变得非常的持续。
Even with A Course in Miracles, we can see this in practice.
然后对在奇迹课程过程中我们这个也是非常重要的一个实践的一个做法。
The publisher of A Course in Miracles and her husband have been married for many years.
然后奇迹课程当时的出版人和他的那个老公实际上是结婚了很长时间的。
They have been serving in a greater plan to make the course available around the world in many languages.
他们在一起实际上是就是在执行一个非常大一个伟大的一个计划，就是要把这个奇迹课程带到更多的人的面前。
And she is 88 years old, and he is 90 years old.
然后他这个出版人现在已经是88岁，然后他的丈夫是90岁。
And there they are still side by side serving Jesus in the plan.
他们到现在还是在并肩的一起在被基督耶稣所利用，一直在为这个奇迹课程所工作。
Yeah. So I think that's a good example of a holy relationship.
所以这个就是一个神圣关系的一个很好的一个例子。
Yeah, to serve a higher calling.
因为神圣关系是要用来被造福于一个更高的目的的。
Yeah. We're going to have a celebration next summer.
明年我们会在我们的修道院做这样的一个庆祝活动。
Honoring those who have stayed together and gone before us to help bring us the Course in Miracles.
是为了纪念那些曾经就是把这个在奇迹课程的这些先驱们他们所做的努力。
So we have invited her daughter to come.
所以我们请了她的女儿来到我们的修道院明年。
Yeah.
我想问一下，就是那个小我啊，它是从哪里来的？它如何产生的？以及它存在的意义是什么？
So David, my question is, where does the ego come from? And what is the purpose of its existence?
Well, the ego does not have a source.
小我实际上是一个没有源头。没有源头，没有来源的。
So it actually follows from nothing.
所以它是无中生有的。
It does not have a parent.
它也没有父母。
So it acts like a wild child.
所以它的行为举止就像一个野孩子一样。
With no mother or father.
没有母亲，也没有父亲。
It does.Have a purpose.
它确实是有存在的目的。
And its purpose is death.
然后它的目的就是死亡。
And hatred.
愤怒、仇恨。
And so that is why it has to be forgiven.
这也就是为什么我们一定要宽恕它。
Because it's not really worth believing in.
因为它实际上是不值得我们去信任它的。
It would be like.Imagining something in this world.
其实打一个比喻，就好像你在这个世界上凭空去想象一些事情。
Having a fantasy or an idea that has no basis in reality.
就好像你凭空的臆造出来一些意象或者想象，但是不是建立在真相基础之上的。
So in that way, the ego is like a phantom or like a ghost.
所以从这个角度上来讲，小我就像是一个鬼魂，或者是它就是像一个臆造出来的一个想象。
It was made out of belief.
它是由我们的信念所造成的，营造出来的。
And when you stop believing in it, it disappears and never was.
如果你不再相信它的话，它也就不会再存在了。
So it is important.To be honest about feelings.
所以你需要对你自己的这个情绪和感受非常的诚实。
The question that you are asking isn't a question that the scribe and her collaborator asked.
你刚才所问的这个问题实际上是把奇迹课程带到这个世间的这个海伦和他的合作者也当时问过这个问题。
First they said there has to be a better way to live.
一开始他们两个人一起走到一起去说我们一定还有一个更好的一条路。
And the course was given as an answer to that prayer.
然后奇迹课程就来到他们的生命中作为是他们这个祈祷的一个答案。
So they were taking down one chapter after another.
所以他们当时就一张一张的把这个奇迹课程给写出来。
Writing down what Jesus was telling them to write.
然后他们把基督对在他们脑子里面所说的这些话都记录下来。
But at one point they stopped and they turned to Jesus and they said, "Can we ask one small question, please?"
然后在他们记录的这个过程当中，突然有一天他们就停下来说，可不可以问一个非常小的问题？
How did this whole separation happen in the first place?
这个分裂到底在一开始是怎么发生的？
And he said, "Well, that's a good question."
然后基督说，你这个是一个很好的问题。
But you should know by your feelings that you believe that it did happen.
在你每天的日常的这些情绪当中，你可以看到，就是你确实相信这个分裂发生了。
He said, "Look at your emotions up and down every day."
那就看看你每天日常的这些情绪，时高时低。
You believe that it happened.
从这个点，你就可以知道，你实际上是相信分裂是发生了的。
Jesus knows it didn't happen.
基督只知道，实际上分裂没有发生。
And that's why he's helping us.
所以这就是为什么只有他能够帮助我们。
Because the ego does not have a real source and it does not have an existence.
所以实际上在真正的层面上来讲，小我是没有源头，而且也没有存在过的。
God did not create the ego.
上主并没有创造小我。
And only what God creates is real.
只有上主创造的东西才有真实存在性。
Love creates love.
爱只能创造爱。
Love does not create death.
爱不会创造死亡。
So we are waking up from a death wish.
所以我们现在实际上是从这个死亡的意愿中清醒过来。
There was a psychologist called Sigmund Freud.
但以前我们曾经有一个心理学家叫弗洛伊德。
And even Freud said that there is something in the mind that he called a death wish.
甚至连弗洛伊德当时都就是说，在我们的心灵中有一个意愿是对死亡的意愿。
And now we know that the death wish is the ego.
现在我们可以明确的知道，这个其实这个对死亡的意愿就是小我。
When you talk to people who seem to be sick,
当你去跟一些是看上去生病的人在做交谈的时候，
or you talk to someone who is an alcoholic,
或者是你去跟那些酗酒的人交谈的时候，
who cannot seem to stop drinking.
然后那些人可能看上去是对酒上瘾的，停不下来的。
Even though they know that the drinking is harmful to them,
哪怕他们是很清楚酗酒对他们伤害很大的。
They keep being drawn to keep drinking.
他们会被一直吸引着去持续这个酗酒的这个行为。
This is the death wish.
这就是一个对死亡的一个愿望。
That is operating in the mind.
就是这个死亡愿望在心灵中是怎么操作的。
And as long as the mind believes the ego is real,
只要在我们的心灵中还相信小我是真实的，
it is attracted to death.
它就会一直被这个死亡愿望所吸引。
Attracted to guilt.
它就会被罪疚所吸引。
And even attracted to pain.
甚至是被这个痛苦所吸引。
And this is, oh, we're getting a drink here. And this is the the human condition.
那这个实际上就是我们人类的这个状态。
A condition that we are waking up from.
也就是我们需要解脱出来、清醒过来这个状态，从这个状态中解脱出来。
那个就是说，这个小我它其实是我们自己创造的一种意识部，这是我们大脑或者我们想象出来的。
So you're saying that the ego is imagined in our mind.
Yes.
是的，是我们想象出来的。
啊，它就是一种，或者就是说用意识部来说，大脑的这种产物，思维的产物。
它是思维的产物。So it's a product of our mind.
Yes, it's a, you might say, a belief of the mind.
它是我们思维的一个信念。
But the mind, as God created the mind, does not believe.
但是我们的心灵，如果是说我们从那个角度来看，我们的心灵是上主创造出来的，这个心灵实际上是没有信念的。
So in heaven, or in nirvana, the mind is in a pure state of love.
所以在天国或者涅槃的状态的话，我们的心灵实际上是一个纯粹的爱的状态。
And doesn't believe anything.
他并不相信，没有任何的信念。
It simply is love.
它就是存在。
So the ego is the first belief.
所以小我是他的一个第一个信念。
And everything about this world is a form of this belief in separation.
然后这个世界中的一切都是对这个分裂的信念的一个营造物。
Now the Holy Spirit had to correct this belief.
所以圣灵的任务是要修正我们这个信念。
So he corrected the belief in hatred.
所以他会需要修正我们对仇恨的这样的一个信念。
With a belief in forgiveness.
然后他的修正的方法就是宽恕。
So this means that forgiveness is the only helpful belief in the mind.
所以从这个角度来讲，宽恕实际上是唯一的有用的一个信念，是我们可以相信的所有的信念中唯一的一个有用的信念。
Out of millions of ego beliefs.
在小我的这个系统中，可能有上百万个不同的信念。
There is only one helpful belief.
但在这个所有的信念中，只有一个是有用的。
And that is forgiveness.
那个就是宽恕。
So we have a saying called "Find the needle in the haystack."
所以我们在英语中有这样的一个俗语，就是说你在稻草中找到这根针。
It's find a very small thing in a very large thing.
实际上来说在这个纷纷杂杂的这个东西中找到真正的一个有用的东西。
And that's why we need the Holy Spirit's help.
也就是这样，这就是为什么我们需要圣灵的帮助才能完成这个任务。
Think for a minute of all the things that you believe in.
你现在来考虑一下你对这个世界所有的相信的所相信的所有的想法。
Time and space,
包括时间、空间
countries,
国家
colors,
颜色
mountains, oceans,
大山、河流
people,
人
male, men and women,
男人、女人
masculine and feminine,
男性、女性
just goes on and on and on.
有太多太多这样的信念
those are all beliefs.
这些都是你的信念
but there is one belief that will.Clear away all the rest.
但是有一个信念能够把所有的这些全都洗刷掉。
And that belief is the goal of A Course in Miracles.
所以这个信念就是奇迹课程的精髓所在。
This book will help you find that belief.
这个奇迹课程整个这个课程就是会帮助你找到这个信念。
And escape from the ego.
然后从小我中解脱出来。
因为这有点还是有点糊涂，我还是不太清楚它 是怎么产生的？为什么会产生这样的一种幻想
？I still don't understand how did we create that? How did it happen? How did the illusion happen?
是不是因为就是咱们缺于这个人像一种物质层面，或是我们把它认啊，就是我认可就等于这个身体，由于这样的一种限制，有些我们很多看不到的东西，我们认为它不是真相。我们觉得我们在这个层面我们能觉察到的，我们以为它是真相，但实际上它是一种幻想，
是
因为这样的一些原因造成这种分裂的这种幻觉吗？
Is that because we believe we are human and that is a very limiting belief, and because of that certain things we think is real is actually not real, and that is how the delusion happened? Is that how it happened?
Well, you could say it's like looking at the ego is looking at the past.
我可以换一个角度来这样讲，就是说看在看面对小我的时候，实际上是面对过去。
So whenever you look at history, you're looking at the ego.
所以每当你去回顾历史的时候，实际上你是在看着小我。
All of history,
所有的历史都是小我。
Now there's a very important part of the Bible.
在圣经中有一个非常重要的一章。
In the Old Testament.
在那个旧约全书里面。
Where there's a group that are escaping together.
然后有就有一伙人，他们一起 escaping。
Escaping, I think it was escaping a disaster or escaping imprisonment.
就有一伙人一起在逃亡。
And they tell this man's wife, they tell Lot's wife, don't look back.
然后他们就跟这个有其中的一个人的这个妻子说，你千万不要回头看。
They tell her, don't look back or you'll turn into a block of salt.
如果你要是回头看的话，你的整个身体就会变成一柱盐。
And I remember when I was a child, I was watching the movie.
然后我当时记得小的时候，我在看这个跟这个故事有关的一个电影。
And I was thinking, oh, that sounds terrible.
然后我当时在想，这个太可怕了。
But she did look back.
这个看了。
And she did turn into a block of salt.
但她是确实也是整个身体都变成了这个盐灰。
And I remember the boom.
我当时感觉到心里一震。
But.So when we look back on the past,
所以每当我们回头看的时候
and we say, how did the past happen?
然后我们就会说，这过去是怎么发生的？
We're looking back in a place where there are no answers.
我们实际上在问这个问题的时候是在不可能在没有答案的地方在寻找答案。
Because we can never find our way back to eternity by looking at the past.
因为我们想回到永恒的一体状态，永远是不可能通过回顾过去而找到的。
The wisest words that were ever spoken is the past is gone and over.
所以最明智的一句话就是过去已经过去了。
And so we can't find the answer by looking at the past.
所以我们每次回顾过去的时候，我们永远在不可能在那个里面找到任何答案。
So where do we look?
那我们到底应该在哪看呢？往哪看呢？
We have to look within and turn within to the spirit.
我们一定要向内看，要向内看，去寻找在内在的圣灵。
To the guidance of the spirit.
去寻找圣灵的指引。
Because we can never find an answer to an impossible situation by looking in the past.
因为对于这个不可能的这些情况来讲，我们是不可能在回顾过去的时候能找到答案的。
So in A Course in Miracles, in the clarification of terms.
所以在奇迹课程里面有一个对那个不同的词汇的一个注解。
Jesus says the ego will ask many questions that this course has no answer for.
然后他当时在里面说到，小我会问很多的问题，这些问题是这本书提供不了答案的。
How did the impossible happen?
其中的一个问题就是这不可能发生的事情怎么发生的。
To whom did the impossible happen?
它是对谁发生的？
And he says there will be no answer.
然后他就说是这个对这个问题是没有答案的。
But he says an experience will come that will end your doubting.
但他当时是说你要去向一个体验去敞开，这个体验最终会结束你所有的疑问。
And that is why I talked earlier that we must be open to an experience.
这就是我为什么在一开始就讲，我们一定要向要让这个体验进入到我们的这个心灵当中去。
And we have to become like little children.
我们要像小孩子一样。
If you sit down with a little child.
如果你跟一个小孩子面对面坐着。
And say you have a choice.
然后跟他说你有一个选择。
We can go and play.
我们可以现在出去玩。
Or I can tell you a story about playing.
或者我可以给你讲一个故事，关于怎么玩的一个故事。
Child will say, "Let's go play."
你小孩肯定会说，现在就出去玩吧。
So Jesus is saying, we can go into an experience of forgiveness.
所以基督就说，我们可以现在就直接进入到宽恕的体验当中去。
Or we could stand around describing and explaining.
或者我们可以坐在一起，不停的探讨，不停的解释这个宽恕。
Very long. He wants us to jump.
这个可以，这个可能是一个很长的一个过程，但是他希望我们就直接到体验的当中去。
Jump into the experience.
直接跳到这个体验当中去。
我最后再问一句啊，就是那个，就是小我它存在的意义，我理解它是不是就是为了让我们去发现。
Okay, and the last question is for the ego, the ego's purpose is that for us to discover who we truly are and wake up from this dream. Is that why the ego exists? So that we can wake up?
No. The ego does not want you to wake up.
不，小我不希望你醒过来的。
Because if you wake up, then the ego is no longer apparent at all.
因为一旦你醒过来的话，小我就不会再存在了。
So the ego is like a parasite.
所以小我就像一个寄生虫一样。
Which needs a host.
它需要有一个寄生体。
So the ego is using the mind as the host.
它是用你的心灵作为这个寄生体。
And pulling from the mind's energy.
然后从你的这个心灵中摄取养料。
To feed its belief in death.
然后不停地滋养它的这一套体系，就是对死亡的这个渴求。
And that is why you must let go of this ego belief.
所以这就是为什么你一定要化解这个小我的这个信念体系。
The mind is to be vibrant and happy and light.
你的心灵是值得是非常有活力的非常有动力的这样的一个状态
Not a slave to a parasite
不能是一个寄生虫的奴隶
So the ego wants you dead
所以小我希望你去迎接死亡的
And the spirit wants you alive
然后圣灵是希望你真正的活着
And in the end that's the only decision to make
最终来讲这个就是你唯一的选择
Would I rather be host?To God,
我到底是想做上主的
host to God or hostage to the ego?
我到底是想做小我的奴隶，还是想做上主的
居所？
我不是说小我他有这个意愿，而是说他存在的价值，他提醒我们了什么。
I'm not saying that the ego wants us.To wake up, but I'm just saying the value of the ego would be so that we can wake up.
The ego doesn't have any value.
小我没有任何价值，它没有价值。
Because it doesn't have a source.
因为它没有一个源头。
Everything of value has to have a source.
任何有价值的东西一定是有源头的。
And God is our source.
上主是我们的源头。
So we are valuable.
所以我们是有价值的。
As spirit,
作为圣灵是有价值的。
我不是太同意他老师的说法。好，我们再谢谢。
好的，刚才这位还是在问说，我突然想到，我来上课之前就要问你的一个问题，突然记起来了，就是我以前 在听同类的奇迹分享的时候，说耶稣的十二门徒谁谁谁投胎，都有份儿啊。你是耶稣的哪一个弟子啊？是在
I've heard that
或者是你是不是
The 12 disciples of Jesus Christ came back to life. And I'm just wanting to know whether you're one of them reincarnated, or whether you are one of them. If yes, who are you?
因为在这个我在听分享的时候，因为我特别喜欢大卫哦，然后他们说。哎，比如说Gary 是哪一个啊？谁谁谁是哪一个？然后我就想，那你是谁呢？如果你不是的话，你就牛了嘛，对不对
？Because there has been long discussions among the people here. They're talking about Gary's past life and other teachers' past life and who they were. So I keep thinking then. What was stated before, if you're not one of the 12, then you're not as special.
Yes, I don't know, I don't put a lot of belief in those things, but somebody told me that I was Jesus' half-brother.
其实我对这些投胎的转世的都不是很相信的，但是我曾经有人告诉我他说我的前世是基督的那个弟兄，就是说他同父异母的兄弟。
哦，好的。不是满意不满意的问题，因为哥哥都认了。如果你都没有份的话，你也没有权杖或者是什么的话，就不太好。因为在此过程也一起，比如说帮您招生啊，或者是什么。
Trying to tell people about your workshop, and people keep talking and asking me about this.
对，但是这个话题就特别搞，是因为这个朋友问说，如果我们往后看就变成岩了嘛，对不对？岩石、
岩柱、
Because just as you said, if we look back, we will turn into a pillar of salt.
就是刚才您说的那个圣经的那个例子，那这个一看过去，如果你是那个，那就变成一个岩柱了，是不是？
对。So that means if we look back, then we will turn to a pillar of salt.
Well, maybe we need to start to talk about quantum physics. Here, or about parallel lifetimes.
可能我们现在其实可以进入一个另外一个话题，就是跟量子力学有关的一个话题，或者是平行宇宙的话题。
So when we talk about past lives and future lives, we have to realize that they're all going on simultaneously.
因为每次当我们在谈到以前的这个过去的轮回转世，还有今后的这个身世的时候，实际上我们需要知道是所有的事情都是在同时发生的。
So Jesus teaches us that the past is gone.
所以基督教导我们的是过去已经过去了。
And the future is just imagination.
然后未来其实是我们脑子里面的幻想。
And the most helpful thought we can think is of the present moment.
然后最有用的一个方法就是把我们的注意力集中在当下。
And so, if all of the lifetimes are happening together,
所以如果不同的生生世世都是同时发生的话，
it's just that the mind can seem to tune in to one channel or frequency instead of another.
所以当我们在说到哪一生哪一世的时候，实际上就是我们的心灵聚焦在这一个就像这个频道一样。
But it's not helpful to think of linear time as being reality.
但是对我们来讲，实际上就是一直把这些生生世世都放在时间线上，然后去这样回顾，对我们其实是没有什么益处的。
You know, you can talk about it in a playful way, like a children's story.
你可以像就是小孩子一样去像开玩笑一样去谈这谈这些事情。
That's what I do with my three-legged cat tripod.
这个有时候我会去跟就是拿我那个三条腿的猫来开玩笑。
Tripod finally died.
我的那个三条腿的猫叫三脚架，它最近去世了。
And she seems to have reincarnated again.
然后她看上去好像是她又轮回又投胎到了另外一只猫身上。
But now she has four legs.
她现在有四条腿。
Before she was a female.
她以前是一个女性的。
Now she is a male.
现在是个公的。
And she has the same meow.
但她的一个叫声和喵的一个叫声是一模一样的。
And I know it's her.
然后我知道她就是三脚架。
But the form looks different.
但是这个形体看上去很不一样。
Like she still wants to be around me. She still wants to be close.
然后现在她还是非常的对我非常的黏，总是缠在我身边。
And so she still lives in the same house.
她也住在我们同一个房子里面。
With a different name and a different form.
但是她的名字变了，她的那个长的样子也变了。
Yeah, but I tell that just in playfulness.
但是我每次在谈到这个问题的时候，总是就是当做一个玩笑一样。
Reincarnation is a concept like all the other concepts.
轮回转世实际上跟我们心灵中其他的这些信念和思想没有什么不一样的。
And so our purpose is to forgive all concepts.
所以我们的任务实际上是宽恕这个概念。
And live in the present moment.
然后就是只在当下的这样的活着。
Yeah. 因为我问这个问题也是中国的好多，比如说法王啊、和尚那些，都是我是哪一个大宝法王的什么什么这个，然后就小小的就可以享受一些权利啊，或者是什么，然后。您是就如果我可以强大的话，您是同父异母那个是吗？
So the reason that I ask this question is,
因为就是在美国在加拿大的那个什么 Silo 啊，就是说的这个就是在奇迹圈内，我们认领啊哪一个门徒啊，或者是什么，就是哪一个再来转世的这种。但这个最好一笑而过，但是这个也是人们谈的最多的，就比如说我是当时是哪一个转世，那我这是很落魄，但是我上世也还是很好的嘛，对。
So there has been a lot of discussions among the people here, you know, about who we were in the past lives, and so it kind of bring up some kind of comfort even if we have a very difficult life this time, but we can say we were someone, this one and that one, in the past life. So I just want to confirm that you are half brother of Jesus Christ.
That's just what they told me. Someone told me that.
有一个人曾经这样告诉过我，我只是被这样告知的。
好的，谢谢。
那个三脚架跟了你那么久，也没进步，就多长出一条腿
儿。那不进步。Just saying, the old tripod didn't really improve much. All that she did was to grow another leg after all.
Yeah, small improvement.
很小的一个进步，是吧？
我就想问戴维老师一个，就是关于课程实际操练中的一个问题。
I want to ask a practical question about practicing of course miracles.
因为我接触奇迹课程差不多快五年时间了，但是这个过程并不是非常顺利。
Because I have been practicing the course for about 5 years and hasn't really been easy.
是我能一直感觉到我的这个抗拒是一直伴随在我整个。
Because I can feel the resistance has always been there with me as I practice the course.
最明显的就是我可能用了2到3年的时间去练奇迹课程的前50课。
For example, it took me 2 to 3 years to just practice the first 50 lessons.
然后，但是呢，我可以看其他的辅助的材料。我看过戴维老师的材料，看过葛瑞的告别娑婆系列，还有包括肯尼斯的书，我也看过。但是我就是看不下去，正文，做不下去。
I can actually read all the materials about the course. For example, I read your material. I've read Disappearance of the Universe series and some books by Kenneth Wapnick, but I just cannot read the text or practicing the lessons.
在见大卫老师前，我在第一百五十三课已经用停了快一年的时间了。
Before I meet you this time, I have been up to lesson 153, but I have been pausing for almost a year now.
然后但是呢，虽然说我对奇迹课程很抗拒，但是在我超越奇迹课程的这个过程中。
Because while I'm practicing A Course in Miracles, I'm also practicing another practice that I encountered before the course.
随着我接触奇迹课程这个进展，我对这个课程、对这个法门的理解也是逐渐的加深。
And as I go deeper with the course, I actually I'm going deeper with the other pathway as well.
就是我现在在这个法门上看到越来越多奇迹的影子，对我来讲，它就是一个简化版的奇迹课程。
And the other pathway, I see so many similarities with the course, and to me, it's like a simplified version of the course.
我感觉我和这个法门是比较有缘分。And
I can feel the resonance with this other pathway.
我会把这个法门用在我日常生活中的每一个事件上的宽恕，以及我的每个起心动念的释放和清理过程中。
And I really try to apply that principle to everything in my daily life, every practice, every forgiveness opportunity.
所以我现在可能花在这个法门上的时间，要比我每天读正文和做练习的时间要更多。So
I spend most of my time in this other pathway, then I can devote myself to the text and the workbook lesson of the course.
我现在有点担心的是，我现在对这个法门的一个倾向是不是对课程本身的一个逃避？
And the concern right now for me is the leaning toward the other pathway, is that actually avoidance of the course? That's my question.
其他还有，然后另外我是需不需要强迫自己从现在回到正文和练习手册的正常的练习上，还是继续我现在的状态，然后等待一个合适的时机，等待一个圣灵的召唤，再回到课程的练习上？
And is that better for me to force myself to come back to the text and work the lesson, or I can just wait until I'm being called again by the Holy Spirit to come back?
Okay. Well, I think it is important to remember that A Course in Miracles says it is a beginning and not an ending.
我们需要记住，奇迹课程它说它只是一个开始，并不是一个终点。And
it is just a pathway to put you in touch with your internal teacher.
实际上，奇迹课程是这样的一个道路，它这个道路是使我们能够跟我们内心的这个圣灵的指引相连接。And
this internal teacher will be the one that takes you all the way to enlightenment.
然后这个内心的导师，实际上才是能够真正把我们带到这个圆满的一体的这个境界当中的。So
the book is a collection of words.
所以这本书实际上只不过是一堆文字的堆积。And
these words are to point you to a way to hear and receive guidance and instruction from the internal teacher.
所以这些文字的目的实际上是把你指向一个正确的方向，在这个方向里面，你可以逐渐的向你内心的这些指引敞开，然后跟着这些指引走。So
for me, I finished really working with the Course in Miracles years ago.
所以对于我来讲，我实际上在很多年前就完成了我跟奇迹课程的这个练习了。
But the spirit inspired me to use many different symbols in this world to make it go faster for everyone.
但是我已经跟内心的圣灵所链接，然后圣灵会指引着我，利用这个人世间的各种不同的现象，各种不同的符号，去一步一步的加深我的这个心灵的练习。
So let me give you some examples.
我可以给你一些实际的例子。
This weekend we are doing a 3-day retreat.
所以像我们这个周末，我们会做一个三天的一个工作坊。
And I think it will be very helpful to share 3 days together.
因为我认为这个一跟大家一起一直过三天的这种强化的这个时间是非常有帮助的。
But oftentimes I do a 6-week retreat.
但是有的时候我会去某一个地方去做一个6个星期的这样一个工作坊。
So people come and live with me for 6 weeks at a time.
在这个时候呢，就是人们会从各地过来跟我一起住6个星期。
We eat together, we meditate together, we watch movies together.
然后在这6个星期的时候，我们会一起吃饭，会一起冥想，会一起看这些灵性的电影。
And in 6 weeks, they can't even believe what how they look at the world.
然后这个六个星期的时间里面，他们就会。对这个世界观做一个完全的改变，然后他们根本就想象不到6个星期以后他们会是一种什么的观点去看这个世界。
A little while ago, we had one of these 6-week retreats.
在不久之前，我们曾经做过一个这样的6个星期的一个工作坊。
And a woman came to it who had been diagnosed with cancer.
其中有一个学员，他来的时候是刚刚被诊断出癌症。
But after 6 weeks, the cancer was gone.
在六个星期之后，他再回去，他检查就没有癌症了。
And she had a whole different outlook on the world.
然后他对整个这个世界的世界观就完全改变
了。Sometimes after 6 weeks, people say they can't even believe what has happened to them.
然后他们有很多人就说，在6个星期之后，他们说他们根本就无法想象这6个星期所发生的事情。
So reading.And studying and practicing A Course in Miracles is, we know, can be very, very helpful.
所以我们知道在学习还有就实践其课程实际上是会非常有帮助的。
But as you open your mind and your heart, the Spirit can use many different things to speed up the awakening.
但是当你真正敞开你的心灵，向圣灵敞开你的心灵的时候，圣灵实际上是会带给你很多很多有用的工具。很多很多不同的工具。
And I could mention like movies, music, and experiential exercises are part of many other things.
比如说，就像有些灵性电影啊，或者是一些音乐啊，或者是一些实践性的一些练习，都是一些各种不同的工具，圣灵可以加以运用。
And in my life, another symbol has been spiritual community.
然后在我的生命中，另外一个就是非常有用的这样的一个符号，就是灵性的社区。
I didn't even know what that was when I was growing up.
在我长大的这个环境里面，我根本不知道社区是一个什么样的东西。
If somebody said, "You'll be part of a spiritual community," I would say, "What's that?"
如果当时有人跟我说你将会成为灵性社区的一员，我肯定会问他那是什么意思。
It's nothing that I knew existed.
因为在当时我的那个经验里面，这个东西是不存在的，不明白是什么。
But there is like a synergy. There is a helpfulness when we just let go of all the symbols of the world and we let them come to us.
但是当我们允许把我们就是我们释放我们对这个世界所有的信念和想法的时候，然后接受圣灵所给我们提供的一切的时候。
Recently, somebody made a comment that they said, your spiritual community is 500 years ahead of anything on this planet.
然后最近的时候，我们曾经有一个人就跟我们说，你的灵性社区比这个世界要先进500年。
So it's almost like a glimpse into the future.
所以在你灵性社区生活实际上是超前了。世界500年，就好像你能够看到未来将来是一个什么样的情况。
And I don't think it's anything that's futuristic, because there have been amazing spiritual communities throughout history.
我并不认为我们这个社区有什么真正超前的，因为在这个历史整个这个过程中有很多非常不可思议的这样的有帮助的灵性社区的存在。
It takes a lot of trust to be in a relationship, any relationship.
所以对我们来讲，实际上要介入任何的人际关系，都需要有一定程度的对这个圣灵的信任也好，或者对你的弟兄的信任，才能使我们真正的敞开，对这个关系敞开。
And I think with the community symbol, it takes even more trust than that.
然后，如果要像我们生活在灵性社区中的话，那么我们所需要的信念就更加要强。
But everything seems to go so much faster.
但是，确实是在这种状况下，一切的进程就变得更快了。
You still have to uncover and face the blocks.
我们仍然需要发现并且去面对我们这些障碍。
But most people would describe it as very intense.
然后很多人对这个经历都会，他们用他们的词汇就是这是一个非常激烈的有矛盾的这样的一个经历。
So even though you describe your journey, it's been very intense with resistance.
虽然你描述你的这个过程，实际上不是很容易的一个过程。
There can be all kinds of ways where.Things will start to loosen up and speed up for you.
但是实际上就是在这个过程中有很多方法，你就是能够使你加速的这个疗愈的这个进程。
And I think this is very hopeful.
然后我认为这个是非常有帮助的一件事情。
In my life, it seemed to go very slow for many, many years.
然后对我来讲，我的这个灵性的进程实际上是非常缓慢的。
But at some point, it just started to go faster and faster and faster.
但是达到了一定的状态了以后，它就开始变得越来越快，越来越快，越来越快。
And the people that I'm around tell me that it's going very fast for them too.
然后现在就是我身边的一些人会跟我说，他们的这个进程现在变得非常非常快。
So I don't think the real question is between.A Course in Miracles and this other pathway.
所以我觉得你真正的问题并不是要在奇迹课程或者另外这个法门当中做一个选择。
I think your heart is calling for things to go faster and faster.
我觉得在你内心深处有一个召唤，就是希望能够在最快的程度上进行疗愈。
And as this happens, it may involve A Course in Miracles or not.
当你有这个心灵的召唤的时候，然后你跟着这个走，有可能是需要练习奇迹课程，也有可能是需要练习其他的法门。
I notice we have a projector here.
我们这里面有一个投影仪。
And a screen.
也有一个投影屏幕。
And a lot of gatherings I do around the world are using a lot of very deep movies.
因为我在全世界所做的这些工作坊，有很多时候我都会用一些很深刻的灵性电影去作为一个工具。
We've probably watched thousands of movies in our mind training.
因为在我们的这个实践道路上，我们可能一起看过差不多有上千部电影。
And our online movie watcher's guide to enlightenment is turned into a whole pathway to God.
然后我们的社区里面有一个就是在网上的这样的一个通过。灵性电影觉醒的这样的一个网站，然后他自己本身现在也是非常的受欢迎，变成一个就是自己的一个道路了已经。
So people who have studied the Course in Miracles for years find this new movie pathway.
So
they're very excited.
所以有很多已经就是学奇迹课程学了很多年的学员，好像发现了这个灵性电影以后，他们就非常兴奋，发现了一个新的一个道路。
And The spirit's use of movies is very miraculous. It can make the mind open so fast.
因为圣灵可以非常好的应用这些灵性电影，它可以让我们的心灵在一种放松的状态下很快的敞开。
Sometimes people will tell me that they have used drugs in their awakening.
因为有的时候我会听到有人跟我说，他们为了在这个灵性的这个里程上，他们会用一些药物。来使他的心灵敞开
，like ecstasy or ayahuasca。
有些毒品的人都不知道怎么办，药物的那个就是草药的这些
能够让他们有一些产生一些幻觉，或者是有一些就是超越身体的这些体验的药品。
But I say to them, well, spend 6 weeks with me watching movies and see which is more powerful, the drugs or the movies.
然后我跟他说，那你不如过来跟我待6星期，然后我们用这个灵性电影一起去觉醒，看看哪个更强有力，是药物有用，还是这个灵性电影更有用？
Because people have sprung into mystical states while watching movies with me.
因为有很多人在跟我一起看这个灵性电影的时候，实际上都是有过这种神秘的体验的。
But they have to trust. They have to really let themselves go into the experience.
但他们确实需要把自己完全向这种经历所敞开，然后完全信任这个经历。
So I think just trust your heart and feel what really resonates with you.
我觉得你需要信任你自己的心里的这个感受，信任自己的直觉，跟着它走。
And whatever makes you seem to go faster and open more quickly, then that's the thing you should go with.
不管是什么样的法门，如果它能够使你的心灵快速的敞开，然后让你处于这种更强的打开的状态的话，你就应该跟着它走。
And be open to new ways.
然后也不要局限于固定的这些法门。要可以看看有没有新的法门，如果能够使你这样的话。
Yes.
大力你好，我想问一下是这样的哈，我像我自己的感觉就是小我的声音还是很强大的，圣灵的声音还是比较微弱的。那我
I just want to share my experience. In my experience, the ego's voice is really loud and powerful, and Holy Spirit's voice is actually quite quiet.
首先，我是想问一下，你是怎么很清晰的知道那是圣灵的声音？
所以，
我很清晰的听到那是耶稣的声音。
So how do you know for sure what you heard is the voice of the Holy Spirit?How do you know that so clearly?
是通过哪一个我们哪一个部位啊，或者是哪一个听到这个音声的？
So where do you hear? Which part of you actually hear?
再一个就是，你能详细的讲一下你具体怎么交托？真正的交托是？
好, and the second question is, can you please talk more about what is true surrendering? How to surrender in a true way and how to forgive in a truest way?
Okay,
thank you, let's go for now.
Well, at the beginning, yes, the ego's voice is very loud, and the spirit seems like a very small, still voice.
在一开始的时候，确实经历是这样的，就是小我的声音很强大，然后圣灵的声音实际上很微弱。
And so, the beginning practice is allowing that loud voice to speak in your mind, without.Feeling you have to follow it.
所以在一开始的这个初期的这个练习，实际上就是允许这个强大的小我的声音去发言，但是呢，又不觉得自己非得要去跟随这个声音。
It's as if somebody pulled up to your house with a big loudspeaker and they pointed it right at your bedroom.
就好像有的人他就是到你的那个房子门前，用一个很强有力的一个广播在向你的房子里面广播。
It doesn't mean you have to leave your house, but you do have to learn to not pay so much attention to that loud speaker.
所以并不意味着你非得要离开你的房子，但是你当时的训练就可以是不被它所影响。
Now for me, when I say hearing a voice or hearing Jesus,
对我来讲，每当我说我听圣灵的声音，或我听基督耶稣跟我谈话。
It's more like a stream of thoughts.
这个实际上我所讲的更加是一个意识流。
Not like an audible voice.
并不是一个声音上面的一个交流。
But I can feel like a sense of of clarity and ease with this stream of thought.
但是每当这个意识流来到我的意识当中的时候，我能感觉到这个对这个是这个的清晰的感觉，就感觉到非常的清晰，非常的明确。
And it was very practical. It wasn't just talking about love, but it was talking about specific things that really relate to my life.
而且它的指引通常都是非常非常实践的，并不只是空谈这个爱是怎么怎么样的，而是对就是我生活中的一些具体的问题，跟我非常有关的问题做一些具体的指引。
It never was pushy. It never was forceful.
它也从来不会推我到一个我不想去的一个状态，它也从来不会强迫我做什么。
It was never commanding and never demanding.
他也从来不会要求我做什么，或者有这样的一个具体的一个就是强迫的这样的一个状态。
There was a feeling of invitation with this stream of thoughts.
我的经历对他来讲，就是总是感觉他是在非常耐心的邀请我。
But the reason I could tell it was coming from the spirit.
但是之所以我为什么能够清楚地知道它是来自于圣灵的原因是
was when I would follow what it told me to do.
就是每当我跟随着这个建议去走的时候
everything was so easy.
所有的一切都变得非常的容易
everything became so carefree.
然后一切都变得非常没有负担
Problems were disappearing.
问题就会在我面前眼前就消失。
All sense of struggle and resistance were disappearing.
所有的挣扎，内心的纠结也会消失。
And the instructions were very, very helpful.
他的那个具体的指引，实际上都对我来讲非常有帮助。
So it wasn't a sense of working out.Issues, it was a sense of receiving direction.
所以我的感觉总是并不是要我去解决一些什么问题，而是去接受他的信息。
So I could tell by the way I was feeling that something was very different.
所以就是从我的切身感受，我能感觉到它是来自于一个非常不一样的一个渠道。
Because.My experience of the world became very easy.
因为我对这个世间上的这些经验也变得非常简单。
And I think you, realistically, you have to clear away a lot of distractions in order to hear or to go with this stream of thoughts.
在实际上来讲呢，就是说，如果要你做到去跟随这个意识流的。实际的指引去走的话，你可能需要清空一些干扰。
It was pretty easy for me to understand the stream of thoughts or even to write it down.
对我来讲，我是非常容易去理解他的这个思想流，我甚至可以把它写下来。
But then it wanted to come through me and have me speak the words.
那最初是这样的，后来就开始变成他想。通过我的嘴来发言
Speak the thoughts
他想让我把这些意识流全都说出来
Like I was being used as like a conduit or a channel
就好像我是作为一个管道作为他的管道来发言
And that felt wonderful as well
就这个当时去按照他这个要求去做也是感觉到非常喜悦
But it was a little awkward at first
但在一开始来讲还是有一些尴尬对我来讲
Because it was so new
因为是一个非常全新的体验。
Everything that comes brand new seems a little strange at first.
每当我们开始一个新的经历的时候，总是感觉到有些不习惯。
But then it starts to feel very natural.
但是当我们把自己交给他的时候，后来就变得越来越容易，非常自然。
Yeah. And what was the second question?
That's it.
That was the
second. How do you know for sure?
And how do you know for sure? Okay. Langley.
I want to share my experience first and then I want to seek some help. 就是反正我是一直是以同住啊，就他问到这个直觉问题，就是刚才我想发言嘛，然后你就会讲到就跟随你直觉，那我就会立刻发言举手，因为我也不知道要不要发言，然后就是这样。但是我想分享一些我最近的经历，就是你们刚才讲到的六道轮回，我刚刚经历一个，就是我自己转世，就是我投胎的经历者。
I want to share the experience that I just had recently, because you guys were talking about reincarnation, and I had this experience very recently that I reincarnated.
很多人也知道我的很多经历，就是我信上帝，然后我现在超度亡灵，然后我现在经过很多事情，都很多生命体验，然后
他在做加牌，帮人超度。
我真的体验到很多全人全在的，就是我就是什么那个状态。然后但是前段时间是我可能我本来在家里面，就是我包括徒步都不吃东西，不能吃东西你知道吧，但是后面我开始吃东西，吃了个跟我老公你出去吃了个什么肉的东西，然后就开始进入一个负面的阶段，就是我开始我是跟他离婚，我都不知道为什么。
让我先翻译一下。
对，
I had this experience that I had many experiences in my spiritual practice, that I was in the role of helping other people to reach a higher state of mind. And in the past few months, I was in a very deep practice. I actually stopped eating. And then when I, after that, I came back to start to eat again.And I had this experience when I went out with my husband to eat. We had some meat, and it felt really bad. Actually, so bad that I want to divorce him.
这翻译有点慢，但是就是我发现，在我开始吃东西以后，吃很多东西以后，然后我就进入一个反面情绪。我后面经过一次，就是我的灵魂在天上，然后我的身体跳河，然后。
And after I started to eat,
我周围人都知道。
After I started to eat again, I started to have all kinds of negative experiences. And I sometimes have this experience that I feel the body is here, but my soul is flying above me.
我家里人都知道，我心
痛顶着。你是说你跳的那个什么？
我跟你说我的状态是什么样子，我从小就是10岁，从小因为我是留守儿童，我从小就装死，我的身体都是死人，所以我是一个死人的身体，但是我的灵魂在那活着，你知道吗？这是一个很奇怪的状态，就是我心好像是说我想的是耶和华，因为我没有认同我是一个我执嘛，我没有跟父母生在一起，我没有人，没有一个人格来说我是谁，所以我从小我不知道我是谁，我是空空如也。所以我很信任上帝。
So I have this experience since I was very little, because I wasn't growing up with my parents, and nobody actually was there to tell me who I was. So I was not identified with any personality self or this body. I actually felt I was Yeshua, and this body is actually dead for me.There is a soul that is alive in this body that is dead.
因为我真的必须讲话，不然我忘，就是我可能我进轮回了什么，不知道我咋去轮回了。就是我前段时间跳了河以后，就是一个要中阴身阶段嘛，就是我在循着往外走。其实我不吃不喝的话，我就是在天上，根本不会下来，知道吗？
I feel like if I don't eat or don't drink, I will stay in heaven. I don't need to be here. I won't be here.So, but I feel like because I came back, and it feels so bad. I'm dead. I've been dead for a long time. And I feel like this body is just host to a lot of ghosts.
然后真的我的身体跳脱，
然后
他就直接弹上来，你知道吗？我家里就师傅和上去了，我家里就觉得心会毛，老公觉得我很牛逼，我家里觉得我很牛逼。
Because I had an experience, I tried to kill myself by jumping into the river, but
I couldn't do it because the body actually bounced back to the ground, and all my family and my husband who witnessed that, I think I'm really something that's out of this world, but I just felt terrible.
我真的不想下来。
I really do not want to come back here.
我小时候死，我小时候会装逼，我的身体就会装逼，装土，在装逼死，就是开始在发呆固定着，然后我身体在固定着，不用脑，就没什么想法，只能徒步啊。
It's very common to me to have this experience where I just stay, I just be. I'm not emotionless or just be still and just be. Pretend that I'm dead, this body is dead.
我跳过亡命歌很好，就是很多人知道我跳过亡命，就我今我后面才知道我身体是黄金身的，那时候已经抽了，但是我不会装很多亡命，很多高龄。然后，但是我吃肉，就是我新婚开始出去吃肉以后，本来我就经常忘记吃饭，七天啊，一个月啊，有忘记吃饭，但是有时候会吃，也是很经常忘记吃饭，但是我开始吃肉以后，我才进了，我就不知道，但我就是开始跟牢不到一关。
So that's just a summary of what I have experienced. That I helped a lot of people to reach heaven after they die, and they all actually live in this body of mine. Sometimes I forget to eat or drink for a period of 7 days or months, and I felt great. But ever since I come back to eating, I feel terrible. I wanted to divorce my husband. I want to kill myself. That's the experience.
只能往这个轮回，什么圈子？奇迹圈子，奇迹圈子。So
because my pathway is of course miracles, so it seems like I can only reincarnate within this circle.
所以我就突然发言吧，就是大卫老师也知道我刚刚，我不知道我什么时候见的面，不知道，记得我们那时候好像见面，但是。
So I think you know me well, David, because I can't remember the first time we met, but it is my state of mind. I don't want to be a human. But I have no choice. I have to keep moving forward.
因为正好你今天讲话，然后我同步，就是我完全跟外面同步，和念头同步，然后也不知道要不要发言，你就说要赶紧跟随你的声音，让你的声音自动流出来。其实我跟孕妇啊，还有什么八卦啊，都是在痛里吗？因为他们都无处不在。Because
I think we really have this resonance, because I was just sitting here not knowing whether I should talk, and you said you should follow your inner voice and allow your voice to come out, and then I thought I should just talk. And I know that this body is both dead and alive, and there is a consciousness around me that is existing right now and right here.
所以说我是觉知下吧，觉知下。So
I feel like I'm just awareness and conscience coming down, is falling into being a human. And I really don't like it. I don't want to come down here.
我好好，就是我自从我那个跳回身体就跳了以后，花了好长好长时间，好长好长时间，我才慢慢适应这个身体，我才知道，才慢慢下来说。
For a long time after I tried to kill myself by jumping into the river, It took me a long time to get used to the fact that I'm here. So this body actually has no feeling whatsoever. I don't have any feeling. I can tell you that even if I throw this body to the wall, I wouldn't feel anything. The body has no feeling. But I feel now I am here in this world. I feel I have to be a normal person here because I reincarnated now into this world. Because after I tried to kill myself, for a long period of time, I didn't really understand where I was, and my husband tried to take me to a restaurant and I ate some meat, and I had dialogue with the meat that I ate, and it actually told me that there's hatred because I eat meat. So I'm saying don't ever eat meat. Even the body is actually having absolutely no feeling whatsoever. It's just like an animal. And you will eliminate the feeling of its own. And I also had a conversation with the eggs that I ate, and they're really just unborn babies. Because of that, I had no choice but to be reincarnated into a human being. Because you talked about reincarnation and you encourage us to share and express, that's why I feel like you want to share this.
I think this is important because this entire world and what we would call the human being is a contradiction.
我觉得你说的这些是其实很重要的，因为整个这个世界，还有是我们定义的作为这个人的体验，实际上都是一个非常矛盾的一个东西。
And the mind knows that there's something that it cannot reconcile between life and death.
因为在我们的心灵中，实际上是知道我们是没法统一生和死。
I show this movie sometimes called Solaris, in which the astronaut goes into such deep experiences.
然后我经常放的一个灵性电影，它那个英文名叫Solaris. 然后在这个电影里面，那个宇航员就会到这个星球上去。
That when he comes back to Earth, he doesn't know whether he's dead or alive.
然后从他从那个星球上回来，回到地球上的时候，他不知道自己是生的还是死的。
And his wife appears to him.
然后他的那个妻子就会在他面前，又出现。
And she had committed suicide years ago, so she's just appearing to him.
但实际上他在这个他的妻子在很多年前就已经自杀了，所以但是他当他重新出现在他面前的时候。
And he says to her, Am I dead or am I alive?
他就问他这个妻子，他说我到底是活人还是死人？
And her answer is, We don't have to think like that anymore.
然后当时他妻子给他的回答是，我们不用再这样想了。
That's not a question that we have to try to solve.
也就是说，这个不是我们需要解答的问题。
And I think some of the disorientation you experience is still believing that there has to be, you have to solve some kind of riddle, where you have to solve something with the human condition.
所以当你处在这个状态中就觉得非常的失落的时候，实际上就是因为你认为你自己还是需要解决一些问题。
But you are exactly perfect as you are right now.
但是你现在的状态实际上是没有问题的，是完美的一个状态。
Jesus talks about that when the body no longer feels at all.
因为基督在奇迹课程里面也谈到了，人的身体实际上是不应该有感受的这个概念。
He's telling us that that's a natural condition when you don't judge in the mind. You lose all feeling in the body.
这个实际上是一个很自然的现象。当你的心灵中不再有任何的攻击和评判的时候，你的身体就不会再有任何的反应和感觉。
And so it's important to give yourself permission to let all these thoughts and experiences just move through your awareness.
所以你需要允许自己让这些所有的这些经历和这些感受都浮现出来。
Without trying to make sense of what's happening.
不要试图的去解释它，或者是去理解它。
Francis and I have these discussions often about not eating.
然后 Francis 和我们之间经常对这个不吃饭这个问题进行探讨。
私人房是真的，真的。
我们
还挺有问题的，我们不想身体了呢，没有。
It's really boring to be a human. It's much fun to just be in heaven.
Yeah, one gives way to the other. So it's this thing of not trying to focus or to analyze what's happening. It's almost like coming into a place of letting go of trying to interpret meaning in the world.
所以就是我的建议就是不要试图去解释或者去理解这些异常的体验，就是不要试图去用这个世界中的任何的经历或者是表象试图去
不是我去理解它，我随时可能会死掉，因为我昨天。
She was just saying that she needs to talk about this because if she doesn't, she feels she's going to die. And recently she had this experience where if she stops eating, she actually feels much better. But as soon as she started to eat, she would have this experience of death immediately. Her body would collapse on the floor. And so there are all kinds of experiences, but the guidance she's feeling is the more she talks about this, the more she will come out of that experience, and she will be more rounded. Okay. So my question is, I just need help, and I think my husband doesn't really understand what I'm going through, so I'm just wanting to seek help. Both of us would need help.
Yes. Well, I do remember you, Ling Ling, from the first time I saw you when I came here to Beijing 5 years ago.
我对你印象非常深，从我第一次5年前来到北京的时候见到你，就是对你很有印象。
And it was the first time that I'd done a gathering where I was just aware of you in the back. You were just dancing and rocking.
然后那个是我当时在北京在中国做的第一次工作坊，然后我在前面讲课，你就在那个教室的后面在跳舞。
As I was speaking, I would just watch her dance and dance and dance in the back of the room.
我一边讲一边就是看着你在后面跳啊跳啊跳舞。
Yes, and so I felt that state of mind that you're talking about where you are just being.
So I can, 我知道你我知道你刚才所讲的你的那种心灵状态就是一种我在的这样的一个心灵状态。
And I felt in return visits coming to see you and your husband, just that stillness and that presence that you're talking about.
然后在我们回到中国以后，也跟你和你的老公见过面，然后我也能感受你当时所处在那种宁静的状态。
And as you keep opening to that and having that experience,
这里失去，就是失去很多功能，知道吗？我也通天通地的。
I know that I lived a very happy life. My soul was very happy, and like I enjoyed dancing and singing, but recently I feel like I've lost a lot of the functionality. Because in the past I remember I can just eye gazing with you for a whole morning, and there's no need to talk. I remember that state.
Yeah. I think what's also happening is that this is where we trust in Jesus to take the steps with us as we let go of what seems to be functioning in this world.
所以就是说我们还是需要把信任交托给圣灵，相信他能够帮助我们在这个世界中一步一步地往前走。
In our community, for example, people are going into these states of mind where they lose functionality of the body.
因为在我们的灵性社区中也有人会时不时地就进入到这样的一个状态，他们就觉得他们自己已经失去了一些功能性。
And so people that I've lived with, like Helena and Kirsten and Lisa and Suzanne and Francis.
So I 跟我一起生活过的很多人，包括我们那边的 Helena, Kirsten, 或者 Lisa, 或者是Suzanne, 甚至 Francis.
They do have had periods where they have lost functionality in the body.
他们都有过这样的阶段，在不同的时候里，他们突然身体就失去了这些功能。
Francis recently was going to cut an apple.
然后最近就是一个例子，就是 Francis 在最近的时间，他要去切一个苹果。
But she absolutely could not cut the apple.
但他完全没有能力去切这个苹果。
But then she was going to cut a lemon.
然后他又试图去切这个柠檬。
But she could not cut the lemon.
但她就完全没有，就丧失了一个功能，去能够拿这个刀去把这个柠檬切开。
But you still have to have faith and trust in the spirit that you are perfectly safe and perfectly cared for.
但是哪怕在那种状态中，你还是需要对圣灵有信心，就是尽管在那种状态，你还是会被照顾着，还是你需要一切都会被提供的。
And that's what you really are calling for right now. It's just a sense of being safe and being cared for.
我觉得你现在是实际上你内心的召唤，在此时此刻，就希望能够感受到你实际上还是被照顾着的，还是这个还是处在一个安全的环境当中。
我知道我会被照顾，我会不会通过自己自杀呢？我身体里面好像有东西。
And I feel I'm scared that this body will kill itself. I'm scared there's something in this body that wants to kill itself.
Yeah. So that's that handing over. You know, it's like if you were talking to a fish that was in water, and you were trying to explain to the fish about the water, but it's all it knows.
所以这个就是需要你信任的时候，因为如果你要是去跟水里的一条鱼去谈这个水的话，它这个水是在它周围它所知道的一切。
So these are the states where you start to make a transition beyond the contradictions of this world.
所以在现在这个时候，实际上一个关键的时刻，你需要从这个世界中抽离出来，进行转换的一个关键时刻。
And I just join with you in prayer that everything that you need will be given you.
所以我现在就是跟你一起做这个祈祷，我就是祈祷你会有这种感受，就是说你所需要的一切都是在提供，就都会提供给你。
You don't have to be afraid that the body will do something or not do something.
你不用担心这个身体会做什么，或者是不会做什么。
It's like Jesus is there to usher us back into this realm of pure soul and spirit.
So, 就是说，基督耶稣会带着我们一直的往这个神圣的这一刻走。
And that's why we are in each other's lives, as comforters and support.
这也是为什么我们需要彼此，在我们的生命中需要彼此，就是因为我们是彼此的，我们可以给彼此带来温暖和带来提醒。
So we're all here to support you in that.
所以我们在这都是一直会支持你完成这个转变。Maybe there is a conflict in my mind. Part of it wants to stay alive, and part of it wants to die.
Thank you for speaking that to all of us. Okay. Well, that's our first day.
好，谢谢大家来参加这个。今天是我们的第一天。
Yes. And as our host was telling us that we have this space for tonight, so if any of you want to come after dinner and gathering here, share together or pray or meditate together, this space is available.
就像我们刚才今天早上那个志明这边讲的，就是说如果今天晚上大家希望用这个场地去继续进行一些探讨的话，那么大家可以跟他一起商量。
Thank you all for coming.
谢谢。